even getting lost is one characteristic of sheep. They just get lost and can't trace the direction to where they were intended to go or to where they need to go back. And that's how we are as human beings. And indeed, we are also prone, just like the sheep, to go astray. And we are at a more loss to find our way back if we do not go back to Jesus. And we, again, just like the sheep, Isaiah 54 reminds us that all have gone astray from the shepherd. So we are very prone this morning to find ourselves diverting, to find ourselves detouring, to find ourselves going in the wrong direction and not following the paths of righteousness. Yet the Lord reminds us that He restores our souls. He revives us when we are exhausted, when we are weary, when we have no hope, when we have lost all faith. He restores us. I am sure you have wondered at some point, just like I also have wondered at some point. But quickly the Lord returns you. Quickly the Lord returns each one of us, because He causeth me to return. Because He readeth me in paths of righteousness, which are paths of pleasantness, paths of peace, and paths of walking in His ways. In the paths of righteousness, it means that we need not to struggle following the road, but we need to struggle understanding and following the word of God and walking in the word of God so that we can find the paths of righteousness. And therefore David knew very well that the Lord was leading him in a straight path, in the paths of righteousness. As a shepherd, he knew he would lead his flocks in greener pastures. So he says, when he's weary, when he is hurt, when he's in danger of wandering, we are in danger of wandering away from the Lord. May we tell the Lord to lead us back to the paths of righteousness. The church is wanting today. The church is wanting today because we have ignored the paths of righteousness. When the Lord is speaking to us every day and calling us to return to Him, we have detoured. Life of righteous path getting detoured. We find ourselves going the wrong direction. It is very, very interesting. The city council, the city government writes, don't urinate here. What do you find? But it's very clear written in big. Why? Because there is that human inclination of wanting to go the opposite of the direction you are expected to go. So when we ignore the word of God, we will walk away. We will be walking away from paths of righteousness. Psalms 119 verse 105 says, God's word is a lamp unto our feet and the light of our paths. If the word of the Lord is going to be in our hearts and we practice it every day, then we will find ourselves coming back to the paths of righteousness. We also find ourselves detoured when we ignore the voice of the Holy Spirit. You know, John 10:27, Jesus used the language of Psalms 23 to explain that as He reads us, we can hear Him speaking to us. He said, my sheep hears my voice. Whose voice do you hear? We need to hear the voice of the Lord, the voice of the Holy Spirit speaking inside us. The voice, that smaller voice that tells you, don't go in that direction. Don't go in that way. That is the voice that we need to hear. Therefore, we can run and hear another Spirit's voice so that in the moments of decision, we will be making the right choices. To choose to walk in righteousness and to stop walking in unrighteousness. Unrighteousness is glorified today as it is important and as it is the order of the day. But we must say no to all ungodliness. We must say no to all unrighteousness. So again, when we ignore the ways of the Lord, this could cause us to veer off from the righteous path, to walk off, to walk away from the righteous path. Are you walking? Are you following the paths of righteousness? How do we go back to the paths of righteousness? John chapter 7, verse 37. In the end, Jesus presents a great invitation to anyone who is thirsty. For anyone who is thirsty, let him come and drink. For out of their belly will flow living waters. Drinking from the well calls us to take a step of faith, to believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, and he died for our sins, and we are sinners and in need of help, and he rose again so that we can also rise up and walk away from our sins. We need to thirst for righteousness. Tell your neighbor, thirst for righteousness. Two simple things. Your heart thirsts. You know, just like a deer pants. You thirst for righteousness. You thirst for walking in the ways of God. You thirst for doing that which is right. So if truly Jesus is the Lord and the Savior of our lives, we should thirst for righteousness' sake. The question is, are you washed with the blood? Cleansing blood.
Are your garments spotless as they white as snow? Are you washing in the blood of the Lamb?
So have you come to a point where you acknowledge your inability to do anything about a certain sin that so easily besets you, according to Hebrews 12, so easily besets you, and you feel thirsty and hungry for breaking camp of sin and walking the paths of righteousness? Jesus is the solution. Are you walking in purity before God? Is there anything in your life keeping you from being sensitive to God's direction as he reveals himself to you? Jesus is the solution once again. Coming back to Jesus, returning to him in forgiveness, seeking his forgiveness, seeking his guidance, and seeking him to lead us. We are all in the era of information technology, and we know that computers get viruses. Maybe yours, my phone crashed last night, so I don't have a phone. And I'm sure it's about viruses. And you know, viruses are bad. So think of a software. It's until you go into the depth of the operating software system that you'll be able to find the root cause of the problem, the virus, and then exterminate it. Sin is like a computer virus. Hey, can you help me to tell your neighbor? Sin is like a computer virus. Imagine, it could crash. Just like a computer, it could crash too. It's like a computer virus. And can't go away without washing of the blood. Just like you need Kaspersky or any other antivirus to clean the virus in your computer. Hey, you need Jesus Christ to wash you, to forgive you, and to cleanse you. So David said in Psalms 139, "Search me, O God, and see if there is any wickedness, and lead me to paths everlasting for your righteousness' sake. Search me, O God, and see if there is any wickedness, if there is any unrighteousness, and lead me to the paths everlasting." Thirsting for righteousness, looking to Jesus alone for the forgiveness of our sins. Finally, our righteousness is like filthy rags before the Lord. It is completely filthy. The more we strive, the more we fail. And Paul said this in Romans chapter 6, "That which I want to do is not what I do, but sin is so easily pulling me aside." Therefore, our righteousness being like filthy rags before God, let us return to God in repentance and make him our righteousness. Let us redig the wells of righteousness, for our righteousness is just filthy. You know those religious things? We do them so religiously and so well. You know, we do them and we do them right. But can you imagine? The measures of God are above our religious metrics, our religious measures. And therefore, let us return to God. Let us ask the Lord to forgive us and heal our souls, heal our land and our nation. Let us walk in righteousness, for without righteousness, no one will see God. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.